गुड आफ्टरनून, आई एम रुशाली धनोकार, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट एट ASMS IOIT पुणे. सो इन माई लास्ट सम सेशंस वी लर्न अबाउट सुपरवाइज अनसुपरवाइज एंड रेनफोर्समेंट लर्निंग, देन अल्सो टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा, स्केल्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट एंड फीचर सिलेक्शन, फीचर एक्सट्रैक्शन टेक्निक. सो हियर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज डिसीजन ट्री, दैट इज कंसेप्ट्स एंड टर्मिनोलॉजीज रिलेटेड टू डिसीजन ट्री. सो लेट्स सी. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट डिसीजन ट्री. सो डिसीजन ट्री इज सुपरवाइज लर्निंग टेक्निक. ओके, एंड सुपरवाइज लर्निंग टेक्निक हैविंग द टू टाइप्स, दैट इज क्लासिफिकेशन एंड रिग्रेशन. सो डिसीजन ट्री इज मोस्टली यूज्ड इन सॉल्विंग द क्लासिफिकेशन प्रॉब्लम. सो आई थिंक वी ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद द ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, राइट? सो डिसीजन ट्री इज ऑल्सो अ ट्री स्ट्रक्चर्ड क्लासीफायर विच हैज़ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ नोड्स, दैट इज पेरेंट नोड्स, चिल्ड्रन नोड्स, and there are internal nodes, external nodes that are present in the particular decision tree. So the internal nodes represent the features of data set, and branches represent the decision rule, and leaf node, that is end of the node, represent the outcome. So I will explain this with the diagram. In decision tree there are two nodes, which are decision node and leaf node. Decision nodes are used to make any decisions and have a multiple branches, and leaf nodes are the output node. Those have decision and do not contain any further branches. So decision or the test are performed on the basis of features of given data set. So let's explain with example. Okay, now see here, this is a structure of decision tree. Okay, the decision node, this is the first node. This node is called as root node. So this decision node again divided into the two parts, that is left subtree and right subtree. So in this left subtree again there is a decision node, right? So this green color decision node is your parent node or the root node, and the left subtree again decision node and leaf node. Leaf node means at the end of the node, this node can't be extracted into the further. And again another side is also a decision node and leaf node. So basically decision tree is a graphical representation of getting all the possible solutions and problem decision based on the given condition. So this is called as decision tree because it starts with the root node and which expands on further branches and construct a tree like structure. So here decision node means a particular condition, or we can say the if condition, and leaf node means either yes or no. In this way this decision tree data structure can be formed. So before start the decision tree, so here is a one example, one term approach used in decision tree, that is what is impurity in decision tree. Now see here in the first diagram, there is a baskets, or there is a collections of apples, and on the another side there is a collections of labels. So one apple match with another label and the label is apple, means their impurity is zero. But on the another side, if the particular basket having different collections of fruits, and in the particular basket they having the different labels, so you need to identify, or you need to identify the possible outcomes or probability how the particular fruit is matched with the particular label. For example, fruit is a banana here and the label is cherry, means their impurity is not equal to zero. So that's why we use decision tree. So each and every phase the particular decision can be taken. So in decision tree algorithm, the first and most important thing is attribute selection measure. So while implementing a decision tree, the main issue is how to select the best attribute for the root node and for the sub node. So for that purpose, attribute selection measures, or ASM, this technique is used. So there are two popular techniques under this ASM, that is information gain and entropy. So let's learn what is information gain and entropy. So see here, the first approach is information gain. So basically and simply, information gain means to find out the best features according the particular condition, or measurement of changes in entropy after the segmentation of dataset based on attribute. So information gain calculate how much information of features provided us about the class. For example, see here in this image, in the first there is a color equal to yellow, right? Height equal to 10. So color and height, these are the features. Okay, color and height, these are the features, and this is called as information gain. Okay, according the features you need to take a decision. If color equal to yellow, so either true or false. If height is equal to 10, then true or false. If height is less than 10, then true or false. So this is called as information gain. You need to identify the features and more metadata related to the features. So decision tree algorithm always try to maximize the value of information gain and also attribute having the highest information gain in the split first. Now the next point is, what is entropy? So entropy means basically the randomness of data. Okay, it is a degree of randomness of data. See here in this example. Okay, so at the root node there is a multiple animals are present, that is elephant, giraffe and all the other animals are present, right? Means there is a highest entropy, highest number of random data is present here. Okay, so after applying a information gain condition, that is color equal to yellow, so yellow animal can be divided into the one class and other than yellow animal can be divided into the another class, right? So there is a entropy is lower, means there is a lower randomness of data. Again after that you need to apply the condition height equal to 10 or height is less than 10. So again is divided into the two classes, height is equal to 10 and not equal to 10, right? Means again it can be divided into the proper classes, means there is a entropy is low. So simply high entropy means high random data and lower entropy means lower random data in this way. So this is called as entropy. So entropy can be calculated by using the probability, means probability of yes log 2 probability of yes minus probability of no log 2 probability of no. So this is a formula of entropy. So both information gain and entropy, this term generally used in the ID3 decision tree algorithm. We will learn this algorithm in next session. So in the ID3 decision tree algorithm we use this term and these formulas. So these are the some effects of entropy representation. Means if color equal to yellow, height is greater than equal to 10, these are the information gain condition, or according the particular data set and particular decision tree will be formed. And this is the accuracy, right? Means color equal to yellow, they divided into the two parts. Again height is greater than equal to 10, again divided into the two parts. So tree can now predict all the classes of animals present in data set with 100% accuracy, right? They can accurately classify those data. That's why decision tree, this graphical representation structure is used. So these are the some advantages and disadvantages of decision tree. Advantages of decision trees is a flow type structure, flow chart, graphical structure, and decision tree generally used for decision making purpose, either yes or no. It also proves to be very useful for decision related problem and also find all the possible outcomes. And decision tree also can be used to data cleaning as compared to other machine learning algorithms. And decision tree handle both numerical as well as categorical data. So this is all about advantages of decision tree. Now the disadvantages of decision trees, there are so many layers are present, right? If extremely complex situation or extremely complex data, this decision tree perform the complex structure. So that's why the result of overfitting. So for solving this issue, we will use random forest algorithm. So random forest algorithm is an advanced algorithm than decision tree. So they solve all the disadvantages of decision tree. We will learn the random forest algorithm in next some sessions. So for the more number of class labels are present, so at that time complexity of decision tree increases. So these are the disadvantages of decision tree. So this is all about decision tree in machine learning. Thank you.